Today I'm making Nautilus plates, soap dish sort of things. 300 grams of clay. I'm going to throw that very quickly to about 7 inches diameter. When I started, plates were the hardest thing to throw, and to be honest, big plates still are pretty tough. Because it's so different to throwing vertically. But what I have found makes the biggest difference is really anchoring yourself to either your body or the wheel, because I've got a solid splash pan, so I just rest on it, wet sponge, and just smear the clay out. But the more solid you are, easier you can keep perfectly level and not let the clay push you around. A bit smaller than I said it was going to be, but I don't want a soap dish being too much bigger than that, so we'll go with that. Got my thick slip, as talked about in the previous video. Do for the Nautilus, if you get too much there. Get your thick slip, wheel turning very slowly, take a soft rib, then from the centre out, just stamp a pattern in it, and then after about a full rotation, just start moving out. The wall up a bit. This is one of the times where the wooden knife is very useful. Finally, the last little trick is I've got cat toy laser pointer, and you can make a non-destructive guide with it. Well, when I say non-destructive, I mean non-physical, so it doesn't get in your way the same way a normal guide would. It's just shining. I don't know if you can see that on the camera, but you've got a little laser dot there, and I can throw perfectly normally, but the next one will be thrown to exactly the same size because I've got my little mark. Hitting the laser. Try and apply a slightly more sensible amount of slip this time. When the syringes get well used, they start sticking a bit, which can make for some very interesting applications. And it suddenly goes everywhere. If anything, this slip is a bit thinner than I like for this, but it's a new batch. You have to use it once to find out, really. As you can see, the wheel's turning tiny bit faster than the last one, which has quite a big impact on how spaced out the pattern is. Some of you might have noticed that I always have to reach down here to adjust the speed of my wheel. It's because this was an old wheel given to me broken, and I replaced about half of the controller board piece by piece, and each time I replaced something else broke, and it was just a 30-year-old circuit board, and it wasn't having any of it, so I ended up replacing the whole thing with the controller from a lathe that used the same motor. Meaning it's all done on a dial on the side of the wheel. Don't have a pedal, and I have to reach down and set the speed by the dial.